guys, welcome to CCKids. How are you doing, Lorna?
Good, thank you. Hi, Steve. Hi everyone. How is everyone?
Well, we're really excited for the show today. We've got a lot coming up. But actually, before we get going, Lorna, I was just wondering, what do you think about my hair? Because obviously, barbers have been closed for a while now. It's getting a little bit kind of like crazy.
Yeah, is the bouffon look the look you were going for?
Well,
the sort of 80s.
Yeah, it's kind of like, oh, I can't think of the guy's name now. But like, is it Spandau Ballet? Is that the kind of the vibe almost, but not really?
Or definitely 80s.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you might want to give it a trim.
Yeah.
How are you going to do it? Like the barber's is shut, isn't it? And hairdressers aren't open and...
Yeah.
You know.
Maybe I'll think about it and...
Yeah. I wonder if someone could do it for you.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe from a distance. I don't know how that would work.
No.
I'll have a think and... Yeah, maybe we'll touch base about it next week.
Yeah, I'll let you know if I think of anyone.
Okay. Real. Cool. Well, enjoy the show, everyone.
Yay.
John the Baptist said, prepare the way. Repent, for there's a Saviour on the way. The Father said how much he loves his Son. Jesus called disciples one by one. Follow me, follow me, follow me. Jesus has the power. Jesus came to save. Gave his life for men. So we'll do what he says. Jesus says take courage. So I won't be afraid. I will follow Jesus. Cause he can hear. Jesus' stories help us understand that God's kingdom's really close at hand. He healed a lot of people and was kind. He even raised a little girl to life. Back to life, back to life, back to life. Jesus has the power. Jesus came to save. Gave his life for many. Lunch. But Jesus multiplied somebody's brunch. He walked on water and he calmed the storm. His power showed the people where he's from. From heaven, from heaven, from heaven. Jesus has the power. Jesus came to save. He gave his life for many. So we'll do what he says. Jesus says, take courage, so I won't be afraid. I will follow Jesus, cause he can heal and save. Jesus did some good, amazing things. He died so he could take away our sins. He was arrested, then got crucified. But after 3 days, he came back to life. Risen King, risen King, risen King. Jesus has the power. Jesus came to save. Gave his life for many. So we'll do what he says. Jesus says take courage. So I won't be afraid. I will follow Jesus. Cause he can heal and save.
chocolate or sweets?
Chocolate.
Bananas or apples?
Bananas.
Custard or jelly?
Jelly.
Genesis or Revelation?
Revelation.
Favourite Bible story and why?
I like the one where Jesus walks on water.
Hi guys, hope you're doing all right. I need the hairdressers to open pretty soon. It's getting a bit awful, isn't it? Might have to give it a go myself, but we'll see. For now, I'm just gonna leave my hat on, I think. Hope you're doing all right. I'm really excited for today's Bible story, and Sue's gonna read that to us now.
Jesus stills the stormy sea. Jesus and his disciples were in a boat when a huge storm arose. It whipped the Sea of Galilee into a fury. This kind of storm could cause shipwreck and drowning. The storm terrified the disciples. Waves covered the boat, filling it with water. But Jesus was sound asleep on a pillow, asleep in a storm. The disciples woke Jesus, crying, "Master, Master, we are perishing." "Why are you fearful, O you of little faith?" Jesus asked his disciples. Then Jesus commanded the wind to stop blowing, and Jesus commanded the crashing waves to lie down and be still. And the wind calmed. The sea became peaceful and still. The disciples marveled, saying, "Who can this be, that even the winds and the sea obey him?"
Thanks so much, Sue. You know, I absolutely love this story. It's one of my favourite stories that shows the power that Jesus has. Jesus is asleep in the boat and there's this massive storm raging. His friends wake him up and he says, "Peace, be still." And the storm stops. Absolutely no more rain, no more waves, no more nothing. It's just peaceful. That's the power that Jesus has. I wonder if there are difficult things that we're facing at the moment. Me personally, I'm really missing my mum and dad. I really find it difficult that we can't go and see them, go and stay with them, go and give them hugs. We're really fortunate, aren't we, that we live in a time where we've got technology, so we can talk on the phone or we can FaceTime or Zoom. But it's still really hard. I think of other people in our church who are maybe sad because their loved ones are really poorly. Some might be in hospital. And it's really hard, isn't it, the different storms that we face. But the good news is that just as Jesus was in the boat with his disciples in that storm, he's with us too in our storms. And Jesus has power, doesn't he? And we can trust him. We can trust him to help us and to walk with us through difficult times. And you know, this reminds me of the ultimate power that Jesus has over sin. See, the bad things that we do that keep us from being with God, Jesus got rid of them on the cross, didn't he? Jesus has the power to remove our sin, to get rid of it once and for all, and that is something worth celebrating. But I think there's also something else really important as well from this story, is that we can know that Jesus is with us in our storms. He's with us right now. And so I would love us to just spend a couple of minutes just having a quiet time with God. You might want to whisper something into your hands as you're talking to God. You might just want to say it in your head. You might want to whisper it into your hands to tell God how you're feeling, some of the things you might be happy about or sad about or unsure about. Just time for you to be with God and for you to tell God that you trust him and for you to know that he's with you, that Jesus is with you in the difficult things that you might be facing at the moment. You might also want to thank God for Jesus and for what he did for you on the cross. So we're going to spend a couple of minutes doing that now, and then I'll pray to close. Father God, thank you so much for your son. Thank you for what he did for us on the cross. God, I thank you that he has the power to take away our sin and that he's done it. And God, we thank you for your son Jesus, that he was in the boat with his disciples and that he calmed that storm. We thank you that he was with them in that time. And we thank you, God, that you are with us now by your Spirit as we face our storms too. Help us to trust you in the week ahead. Amen. See you very, very soon, guys. Take care.
People through the
get to know our God again. The Lord is good, the Lord is strong, and we will live our lives with Him. Oh, thank you, oh, thank you, that all through history you're faithful. Thank you, oh, thank you, that you
Holly Prankster, and I'm coming at ya. Now, CCKidders, have you seen Steve Weston's hair recently? I'm not sure what look he's going for, but man, it's big. It's big these days. I thought I would do him a favour and give him a little trim. What do you reckon? Bit off this side. Bit off the top. And a bit. God damn, that's me. Went rather well, I thought. I think I'm quite good at this hair dressing malarkey. Book now to avoid disappointment. Welcome back, CCKidders. Hope you enjoyed the show. Don't know where Steve is. Oh, here he is. Hey.
Hi.
Did you enjoy the show?
Yeah, loved it.
It was a good one, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Are you okay?
I'm all right, yeah. Just a bit cold. Head's a bit cold, so I thought I'd put my hat on.
You don't want to take it off?
Not really.
Okay.
But I should probably give it a week before I take it off. So if you want to see what it looks like, maybe tune in next week and... Yeah.
Okay. We'll leave it there. Right. Have a great week, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.